We're out here at a customer site doing a CCTV inspection and a flushing. We're right next to the roadway. Now what they had was the sewer system here from their toilets from this community facility here beside us. They weren't flushing, they were backing up. And that's obviously a concern when they have a lot of people coming in. The city came out allegedly and said that there's stone in their manhole here. And that stone indicates that they have a possible crack in their pipe. So the first thing we had to do was flush out the city side connection because it was clogged completely. And this particular hatch beside me, when you looked into it, you couldn't determine that there was even a pipe in it or a trough in it. It was completely full. So the first thing we had to do was find out where the pipes were coming into it and flush out and clean the city side to get flow. Then we flushed inward towards the building to get flow. We had to clean this whole system out from being completely clogged. That cleaning then allowed the crew to put the camera in, and it became immediately apparent what the issue was. The pipe actually dips, so you need to have your pipe on an incline so that the fluid will flow down towards the city. And in this case, the pipe comes down and then comes back up to this particular manhole. And that means that either one of two things happened. Either it's collapsed and cracked and we've got a gap in one of the seams, or it was built that way. In other words, whoever put this in dug across and then realized that their incline didn't meet the hole in the manhole and went, okay, well, we better get it up to meet it. So let's hope that's not the case, because that's a very complex correction. That means going right underneath this building and resetting the whole line. Hopefully it's just a collapse. So we were able to determine that because the camera went in and went from being above water, and as we pushed it in, it went into water and actually became submersed in water and then came out the other side and dry. Now you expect it to go uphill and it to be dry, but you don't expect to be dry at the access point and then progress into water and then back up. Gravity, that indicates that things are flowing towards the building, at least in this case for about a 2-meter, 3-meter section. So the crew was also able to locate that distance of that dip and that low point using electromagnetic locating devices. So we're able to determine where the dip is. They now know that they've got a problem with that pipe and they're gonna have to dig it up. Here's the secondary issue. There's gravel in this manhole, and that gravel in this manhole has to be coming from somewhere. And what we're able to see is it's coming out from around the pipe. So the city side pipe is concrete and it's sealed in with concrete, but on the customer side, it's a PVC pipe. So plastic pipe, a green plastic pipe. So it isn't sealed properly to the concrete shaft of the manhole, and the grouting is gone and the stone is falling in. Another indication that water is coming around the pipe as opposed to through the pipe. So if there's a crack in the joint a couple of meters upstream, that crack allows the water flowing out of the building to go around the pipe and flush and rinse. And we believe that that has contributed to stone starting to fall out into this manhole's bottom. And we obviously had to clean that out and get proper flow going through. Now, the big question is, they've got to dig down and determine what's going on with this pipe and fix it and hope that the finished fixed elevation is still on an appropriate incline to allow the fluid to properly flow into the city sewer systems.